Okay, and welcome to Newberry Nights. My name is Garth Knight. I'm your host of the show. This is a new show on Channel 2 this fall. And the concept of the show was sort of like a late night, sort of like a Conan O'Brien or David Letterman, meet the Saturday Night Live or a Mad TV. My guest tonight on the show is Kevin Strickland. But before we do that, I want to talk about a movie that the cast and crew looks at every week before we do the show, kind of a movie review, if you will, sort of like a Siskel and Ebert, even though one of them's not around anymore. But anyway, we're going to do the Newberry Nights Weekend Review. So you guys take a look at that.
Shh. There's something outside. I don't know what it is.
It's nothing from this world. Or Plymouth.
Random voice.
Yeah, today's movie is X-Men.
Oh, shake thanks. Shake my hand. Shake my hand.
Burbank, belay that order. It just looks like some kids are playing Ultimate Frisbee.
With hubcaps.
Crazy kids.
As the UFO landed in a graveyard.
And ran out of gas.
Is that a string?
Hey, Bo.
Did you poot?
I've been working in the graveyard.
Well, it was me.
I love how life always has a soundtrack.
Mm-hmm. Hey, the graveyard's on fire. You don't see that every day.
Nah, not really.
Oh my god. It's Mannequin 3.
I like that movie.
Yeah. Sucked.
Scratch my back with those hands.
Do you want to dance? I guess not.
Whew, that was great.
And she wasn't invited. They never really liked each other. Why? It'll just get light again in a few minutes.
Yes.
Oh, watch out for that tree.
Oh no, who's gonna dig their graves?
I thought they were sleeping. We just got a call, boss. Back up, hurry up, I was eating my donut.
Make sure we've got some dramatic music for this scene.
Wow.
The exit from Krispy Kreme.
Hey, you might want to turn those lights on. There is an eclipse going on, you know.
Yes.
Oh, never mind.
What an eclipse. The quickest ever.
They drove night and day, and back into night again.
And the clips is coming back now. What an eclipse. I am an immigrant.
Well, they are dead, you know. It's kind of hard to take a statement from a dead guy. Yeah, I don't know who left those dead bodies lying around. We'll fix that.
Call a morgue.
And might head to Krispy Kreme.
This movie sucked.
Worst movie ever.
Yes, I'd have to agree. What do you think, Adam?
Adam. He's asleep.
Ah.
Oh, well. Let's get out of here.
Okay, and welcome back. Hope everybody enjoyed that. My first guest tonight is the president of the student body here at Newberry College. He hails from Lexington, South Carolina. Let's go ahead and meet him, everybody, Kevin Strickland.
How you doing, bud?
Good to see you.
All right, Kevin, how you doing, buddy?
Doing pretty good.
How's everything going for you?
It's going.
So I hear you're a pretty busy guy this time of year, doing a lot of stuff for the student government. How's everything going?
It's going pretty good. It's busy.
Really?
long days.
So tell me what your schedule's like during the week, what all goes on. I know you're a busy guy. I know you had a student government meeting this morning, so how'd that
go? Yeah, I usually run about 6 or 7 miles in the morning, mm-hmm. and then cook meals for the homeless.
Really? Like you're in shape.
Yeah.
More round.
I'm buff.
Square, but it's okay.
It's John Miller's cafeteria food.
It is John Miller's cafeteria food. So the word on the street was that you weren't at the convocation.
I was not at the convocation.
Mm-hmm. And can I have an explanation? You grew up in Lexington around the church. You're a great Lutheran guy. I want to know why you weren't at homecoming. Because you make the keynote speech. You left poor Lisa Wessinger to do the speech, the pretty little girl in front of everyone. I want to know about that. What was the excuse?
I figured they'd rather see a beautiful Kappa Delta than they would rather see a not-so-handsome guy.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided to speak at St. Philip's Lutheran Church, where mm-hmm. I work as the youth and parish life director.
Uh-huh. So you just thought it would be better if Lisa did that and you did homecoming?
Yeah, I had already been assigned to speak at St. Philip's before I knew we had a convocation.
Oh, okay. So sometimes it conflicts with you, huh?
It does conflict, yeah.
Yeah, I guess you know where your priorities are, huh? Priorities, guys.
Yep.
That's where it's at. Anyway.
God before Newberry.
Okay. Well, I grew up on a farm in Page on South Carolina. No one knows where that is. Tell me what's growing up in Lexington, how it was like, what all went on there. I know there's like a building there tall in Columbia, the Lexington area. I grew up on a farm. I milked cows. What was growing up in Lexington like? Tell me about that.
Yeah, we had cows in Lexington, but they were more so Chick-fil-A.
Ah.
so, you know, the big skyscrapers, lots of busyness, cars and stuff. Actually, Lexington, it's not too big. The high school I went to was huge.
Yeah.
But it was fun.
That's cool. Well, why don't you tell me about, I know you had a busy summer, did a lot of stuff. You've already said you work for the church, did a lot of stuff with the church. You're a busy guy. The church, and you're the youth director, right? Mm-hmm. Well, tell me about what you did. I know you volunteered at some camps. You also worked, and then you worked at Newberry College, too.
Right.
So why don't you tell me about what all you did this summer?
I worked at the admissions office along with I volunteered my time at Luther Ridge,
mm-hmm.
Lutheran camp in North Carolina.
Right.
And went to a few national gatherings in Atlanta and Alabama, and mm-hmm. in fact spoke at an Alabama gathering on behalf of the college.
Okay, well, that's good. I also heard you did something else this summer. I hear you're an avid horse rider. Heard you are a equestrian champion of the world. Why don't you tell me what happened this summer? It's just a bird told me the other day that you're good at riding horses. What happened this summer with the horse?
I'm good at pretending like I know how to ride a horse. it almost felt like the horse rode me. I got kicked off the horse. I was trying to act like I was an avid horse rider and trying to impress a bunch of people.
Ah.
And I come to find out about 2 minutes into the ride, the horse went bucking down the field, and I'm hanging underneath the horse with my legs sprawled up. Needless to say, I almost broke my rib, but I didn't. I won't be getting on a horse anytime soon. We didn't have those in Lexington, so.
Yeah. So you're trying to impress the chicks, huh?
I'm trying to impress the chicks.
Yeah. You're a ladies' man, that's what I hear.
I'm a ladies' man.
So you're a Lutheran, a ladies' man, and just, you're just the man, pretty much.
They go hand in hand. Yeah.
They do go hand in hand. Okay, well, Kevin, stay with us. We're going to we'll take a quick commercial break. We'll come back with you and talk about student government a little bit. I know there's a lot of stuff going on this year. So you guys stay tuned. We'll be right back with more of Newberry Nights.
When I grow up, I want to be a doctor because doctors help people.
When I grow up, I will be the president because that would be really cool.
When I grow up, I'll be an artist because I love to paint.
Children are full of potential, but they need a healthy start. Let WIC help.
When I grow up, I want to be a mommy because mommies are the best.
For more information, call your local DHEC Health Department.
No one plans to get a sexually transmitted disease. No one plans to get pregnant at 13. No one plans to drop out of school. But it can happen. Here's the plan. It's okay to wait.
Can't pretend I don't care when you don't think about me.
What? You want to get pizza?
Yeah, man.
Let's see. Who should we call?
Tombstone. Definitely Tombstone.
No, man. DiGiorno. They're faster.
Are you crazy? We're going with Tombstone. Forget about it.
You want to make it interesting?
What do you got in mind?
We call them both. First one to get here wins. Loser pays.
You're on, man.
Hello, everyone, and welcome again to Pizza Wars, the extreme sport challenge show where we pit two pizza delivery drivers against one another in a race against the clock. Everyone knows here tonight that more than pride is on the line, because everyone knows that the driver that shows up second to the victor goes the tip.
Action. What do you want on your tombstone?
Deliver this.
And now let's take a look at the tail of the tape. And tonight we're looking at two battle-hardened competitors here. Our tombstone driver's driving a 93 Nissan Maxima with a V6 engine and has a fastest delivery time of 15 minutes, 8 seconds. He also holds a national record of 65 consecutive on-time deliveries, which is amazing, and he's held that record for 3 years now. The DiGiorno driver, on the other hand, utilizes a 91 Chevy Lumina, also with a V6 engine, and has a personal best delivery time of 14 minutes and 47 seconds. Very, very impressive. He also holds the current record tip with a $25 tip on a $13.97 stuffed crust pepperoni pizza with mushrooms added. Very impressive. Some things to think about on disabilities, disadvantages, and advantages. The DiGiorno driver has no rearview mirror, so his blind spot is incredibly, incredibly just blown out of proportion. Cars behind him, cars in front of him, difficulty to himself. And also, to his disadvantage, the tombstone driver has a CD cassette combination inside the car, whereas the DiGiorno driver only has a cassette. So on the lonely nights when you're about 12:25 going into Cromer, that's difficult if you got a stuffed crust meat lover's pizza. But that's just me, ladies and gentlemen. So let's get it going.
Tombstone Pizza, what can I get for you?
DiGiorno delivery.
A large pepperoni pizza? Yes, sir.
You'd
I'll be right there.
A large pizza? I'll have it there as soon as I can.
What is it, relay? What's going on here? You got the
gentlemen, start your engines. And we're off with our DiGiorno Tombstone Pizza Delivery Challenge. In the studio with me is my colleague, Billy. How are we doing tonight, Billy?
I'm doing just fine, John Boy, and I'm ready for a good race.
Absolutely. We've got an incredibly exciting race ahead of us tonight. In this car, the 1991 Chevy Lumina is our DiGiorno driver. His opponent tonight, in a 1993 Nissan Maxima, is our Tombstone driver.
And it looks like our DiGiorno driver is pulling out of the pizza lot now, and he's looking confident, very, very confident.
Well, he should be. He's off to an early lead, and it looks like he's intending to wrap this thing up right from the get-go.
Yeah, well, that's what everybody hopes.
All right, now let's check out our Tombstone driver. He is currently making a turn out of the parking lot. He's already fallen a little bit behind. This has got to concern him.
Yeah, it would concern me, because that DiGiorno driver, even though he's got the older car, he can do it.
Absolutely. He's got a little bit of a lead foot, too. He wears a size 12 shoe, and that gives him just the slightest edge over our Tombstone driver with his 11.5. That half a size shoe difference doesn't sound like much, but it can translate to a lot of speed.
Let's not overlook the Tombstone driver's long arms. He's got exceptionally long...
Wait, Billy. We've got a red light here. That's going to slow him down. No, it isn't.
He's making the right turn.
That is going to shave valuable time off of his delivery.
Man.
That time also translates to money. This driver knows his business.
Yes. And now, let me go back to what I was saying. Our Tombstone driver has a slightly longer arm span than our DiGiorno driver, which gives him more maneuverability in this situation. Although the DiGiorno driver has thicker arms, broader arms, which gives him more control during the turns.
Absolutely. Not only gives him that, but it gives him a little bit more control at all times. Just help him hold that wheel a little bit straighter. You know, that's always valuable in making sure the cops aren't looking out for you too much. Our Tombstone driver manages to keep a radar detector in his dash, but it doesn't look like our DiGiorno driver has one. Well, that's almost always the case. I'll tell you, I really wouldn't think this was a 93 from seeing the interior. It seems like a much newer car.
So, he should be able to monitor all of the public officials' activities.
Very, very smart for a delivery driver. All right, now as you notice, both of these drivers have half a tank of gas, and that tells you a lot about these drivers. because DiGiorno and Tombstone drivers typically like to fill up their tanks before a night, which tells you that already, even at this time of night, both of these guys have made a lot of deliveries.
Well, I can see by the looking at his watch, the Tombstone driver, he's a little nervous.
He is a little nervous. He knows he's lost some time back there early in the start of the race.
And the DiGiorno driver still looking very confident, even cocky maybe.
Not even looking behind him to see where that Tombstone driver is. Although it really wouldn't do him that much good because he doesn't have a rearview mirror.
That is definitely a disadvantage to the DiGiorno driver. But that's also goes into the fearless factor. Because he's not concerned about sideswiping somebody. He's only concerned about getting that pizza there.
But he doesn't have to be concerned. As you can see, the roads are practically empty. There's no one around him. And here we go. This is very critical. This is a major turn. If he over-rotates this, he goes right into the parking lot, and that is not good.
Oh, and he made the turn.
He looks to have held that turn, and that every turn is critical.
Control, control, control.
Absolutely.
I told you about this, man. Very controlling.
All right, here's our Tombstone driver. Now, he has definitely fallen behind here. This is the time when he needs to really be at his best.
We were doing 41 back there, by the way, and believe me, the rush was threw my hair back.
Now, I'll tell you, not many vehicles could do this kind of speed, say, 100 years ago.
Oh, no. 100 years ago, we would definitely be rolling on, square wheels?
Well, maybe just wooden ones. And I think now is the time, as you can see, to throw caution to the wind. This is only a 30-mile-an-hour zone. He's going 35, though. This is one of those instances where speed limit's just a suggestion.
Oh, yes. And I just want to point out another thing. You said that the gas tanks were all at half, right? Well, I think that might say something about both these drivers. Like I said before, the Tombstone driver, a little nervous. He may think his gas tank is half empty, although the DiGiorno driver, gas tank half full.
Exactly.
I think that says a lot. Oh,
oh no, this is horrible for our Tombstone driver.
The terrible grandma driver's out on the road tonight.
Grandma just got a new SUV and doesn't know how to use the gas pedal, and it's killing our Tombstone driver here. He is just stuck. You can see our DiGiorno driver.
No
He's
worries.
On the home stretch. He's calm. He's at ease. I know the butterflies are there in his stomach, but he's done this 1,000 times.
The experience really shows on his face.
Absolutely. I tell you, it also shows on those odometers. This car is a 1991. It's got 120,000 miles on it. Now, the experience edge, though, does go to our Tombstone driver in the Maxima with 164,000 miles.
That's about 40,000 miles more for the
right.
Maxima.
And that's probably about 4,000 more pizzas.
Yes, that's a lot of pizza.
That is
Sean
a lot
Boyd.
Of pizza. All right, Billy, we're coming down to it right now.
Oh.
We're coming into the home stretch. This is the nitty-gritty. This is where everything is on the line. And even these drivers know these last few steps are critical. Now everything comes down to that run to the door.
You got the system for total control. Now is there anybody out there? Now watch yourself for you, because we can't go. What is it really that is in your head? What is
Hey, DiGiorno. Pay the man.
And we're back here on Pizza Wars. The war has ended. The 91 Lumina DiGiorno Pizza is the winner. What do you think the difference was? They capped it off. Heard there was some foul play. We're not going to go into that here at Pizza Wars. What was the difference? What prevailed you to victory?
The green lights. I just sailed right through all of them, didn't have a red light the whole time.
So no red lights, smooth driving. The record was on the line. You prevailed. You're going to the semifinals. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling great. I'm ecstatic.
Okay. You had the lead. You drove well. You've got the record for pizza time. 65 consecutive on-time deliveries down the drain. Your thoughts?
Well, I'll tell you what. When the competition doesn't play by the rules and cheats, of course he's going to win. But I'll tell you what. Next time, there are no rules, baby. It's
wow.
All me.
Well, I guess you heard it here, guys. Pizza Wars is coming to an end. Tough battle. World records. Everything on the line. The preliminaries. I guess maybe he'll get a shot in the semifinals. We'll see what happens when we come back on Pizza Wars.
Ma'am, your husband's showing signs of a stroke.
I just came home. He was on the floor near the sofa.
He was confused. He couldn't talk or stand up. I called 911.
You did the right thing.
The operator said the ambulance was on its way. I didn't know what to do. I just held him. Will he be okay?
Your fast reaction probably prevented any long-term damage.
WIC, Women, Infants, and Children.
7 million people each month
get rich.
¿Cuánto dinero?
What does it say again?
Save money.
Grow big and strong.
Eat.
Infant formula.
Cheese.
Are you under five?
Free. Four and a half.
Breastfeeding.
You may qualify.
All right, welcome back to Newberry Nights. I have with me the president of the student body here at Newberry College, Kevin Strickland. Talked about he being the ladies' man pretty much on the show, but got to talk about more important things now. You're the student body president of Newberry College. I know it's a tough job. Somebody has to do it. When I was coming through my freshman year, a good friend of mine, Jason Taroque, was the he was the president of student body, believe it or not. And I thought he did a good job, but just tell me what's changed about you since you've been president of student body. I know a lot more. You know, responsibility comes as you're doing it. Just speak about that for a second, if you will.
Okay. I mean, my schedule's pretty busy. I have to go to a lot of meetings that I don't really want to go to, mm-hmm. but have to go to. You know, you get asked to do things that most students probably wouldn't want to do.
Right.
But you do them because, you know, that goes along with the territory.
Right.
But it's fun and it's exciting. You get to meet a lot of people.
You get to meet a lot of people, and it's a lot of fun. So let's talk about some of the things that are going on with the Student Summit. With upcoming events with the student government. First thing is the Student Summit. I know a lot of people don't go to it. It's a very good thing to go to. It's the first one, September 23rd at 5 o'clock in Coffin Overflow, I believe it is.
Yeah.
Why don't you tell me about what Student Summit is, what it's about, and how the students in Newberry College, as well as the community, can voice their opinions in the Student Summit.
Okay. The Student Summit is will be an open forum with all the department heads, and we'll give a chance for students to come and air their views along with giving pros to the college.
Uh-huh.
And hopefully change some things that they're not quite sure of.
Okay, that's definitely interesting. And I know a lot of people don't turn out sometimes. Usually the same group of people, probably 10 to 15 students, a couple of people from the community, of course, President Zace, and all those, including yourself. And it's a good thing to go to. If you get a chance to go to it, I really would encourage that. The next thing is Newberry Idol. Now, this is something everybody's excited about. September 30th at 8 p.m. It is when the show happens. You're trying to get people to get on it right now. Sort of a spinoff of American Idol. Why don't you tell us about that?
Yeah, the Newberry Idol will be held during the week of homecoming. And in doing so, this will be a variety show. Anyone can participate. You don't have to be a Greek. You don't have to be an organization. Just if you're interested, it'll be co-sponsored with ACE. And we'll have prizes for first, second, and third winners, along with door prizes. It's going to be at 8 o'clock in Eliezer Arena on September the 30th. If you have not registered, please do so by next Friday the 26th.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so Friday the 26th, the last day to sign up for that. And I hope we'll have a good turnout. We're still having it in the gym, you think?
Or, right.
It's going to be in Eliezer Arena. I have trouble speaking tonight. Anyway, it's going to be Eliezer Arena. Should be good. Sorry about that. But it should be a lot of fun. Hopefully it's going to have a big turnout. The next thing is homecoming. October 4th, 7 p.m. 7 p.m. is the game. Lenore Ryan. I don't know if they have a good football team this year, but we do. So what do you how do you think it's going to turn out? And what all is going on at homecoming this year?
We have a lot of stuff that the day before is pep rally. We also have three bands playing the Saturday of homecoming. And prior to the game, we'll have the football. The parade.
Okay. All right. So the homecoming should be very interesting. Every year it's a lot of fun. A lot of people turn out for it. So it should be a lot of fun. And if you're watching in the community or watching on campus, Kevin lives off campus. He's too good to live in the dorms with the rest of us, which, he's bad. You know how that goes. But anyway, if you want to contact Kevin, you can call him at 321-2324. It should be down here somewhere. Just give him a call, and he'd be happy to talk to you when he has some time. And he has an answering machine, so leave him lots of messages. I do a lot. They're usually crazy messages. But, Kevin Strickland, thanks for being on the show.
Thanks, Garth.
And I'll hang around for a minute. We're going to show a kind of a public service announcement for some guys that we've heard about. Maybe a myth, may not be. Some guys that they kind of take care of Newberry, have their big rigs. The guys, they take care of Newberry, Newberry College. It's the Ninja Truckers. Why don't you guys check that out?
Here's your bread.
This is good. This is real good.
Give me all your money or else.
Or else what?
Or else I will shoot you.
Oh my God, don't shoot.
This is like a job for the Ninja Truckers.
The who?
Not the band, the Ninja Truckers. Do you care if I make a phone call? It's an emergency.
What? No, I'm in the middle of something. Make it quick.
I bow to you, Master.
Meanwhile, back at the Flying J, our heroes practice our ninja skills. Phone is ringing. Hello?
There's a robbery at the Waffle King.
At the where? Who?
What's going on?
Waffle House is being robbed.
No! Why, crew world? Why?
Quick, to the big rig.
Oh my God, is that the Ninja Truckers?
Yes, it is us. The Ninja Truckers.
You have disgraced me. Now we must fight to the death. Ha ha ha.
So
ha,
be it.
Ha, ha.
Oh no!
Ha.
You're a worthy adversary. You're no match for the dragon.
Ninja Truckered my butt, ha ha ha. Take that, ooh, ah, and that, ooh. Ah, Macho Man, ha ha ha. Look at you now, ha ha ha.
Oh no, Ninja Truckered JR.
Ninja Trucker Ralph, you're my hero.
So girl, you wanna get out of here?
But what about him?
They'll be fine.
Okay.
All right, and that's our show for this evening. I'd like to thank everyone for tuning in. If you like the show, if you like what you saw tonight, please tune in again. The times for the show are Monday at 11 p.m., Tuesdays at 9 p.m., Thursdays at 9 p.m., Fridays at 10:30 p.m., Saturdays at 10:30 p.m., and also Sundays at 7:30 p.m. So the only days we're not on television are Wednesdays, and that's, of course, for church. So anyway, thank everybody for tuning in. We're going to be doing a lot of bands and stuff out in the field too soon, probably at Lucy and Earl's and places like that in the community. So if you guys want to come out and give your support there, that'd be appreciated as well. But I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in. I'm Garth Knight, and I will see you next time on Newberry Nights.